Hello and welcome to this Design Cuts video tutorial. Today we're looking at cleaning up scanned line art. So I have a line art drawing here that has been scanned at a high resolution. I suggest that you always start with a high resolution scan and try and get it as clean as you can in the scan itself. But this needs quite a lot of cleaning up. One reason for this is that I want this line art to be on a separate layer. So I want to be able to, for example, put something behind it. So it needs to be extracted from the paper background. It also needs quite a bit of cleaning up. We'll start by making the background layer a regular layer. In the most recent versions of Photoshop, you just click the lock icon. In earlier versions, you'll need to double click the background layer just to turn it into a regular layer. We're going to extract the white paper from this first of all, and to do this we're going to use the magic wand tool. It's really the simplest tool to use for this purpose, but the magic wand tool has two really important settings that are going to be vital to us, and that's the tolerance and contiguous. Contiguous means that when you click on the magic wand tool, for example, if I click in the hat here, the selection of pixels is limited to a group of pixels that are all attached to each other. So you can see I can get the ones inside the hat, but nothing else. So we want to disable contiguous so that when we click on some white paper, we're going to select all the white paper in the document. And the tolerance is important too. This varies between 0 and 255, and it says to Photoshop, when I click on a pixel, I want you to take some additional pixels of colors similar to the one I'm clicking on that are in the document. So the bigger the tolerance, the more pixels are going to be selected. So for example, if we chose 255 and if we click on the document, then the entire document's been selected, black, everything. So we obviously don't want a really high value. But we don't want a really low value either, because if we select a value of say 1, I'm just going to deselect my selection here and click on the document, then we're only going to get pixels that are pretty much the color of the one under the cursor and very, very close to it. And you can see here we've got lots of marching ants all over the place. So other pixels of color are not being selected, which are colors that we really would want to get rid of. So for a document like this or an image like this, I would start at something like 15. That's a pretty good value for picking up the variety in the paper, but not the black. So I'll press Ctrl or Command D to deselect the selection I already have, and I'll click once in the document. And that selected the white pixels. At this point, if I'm pretty happy with that, I'll just press Delete because I've got a layer which is a regular layer. So if I press Delete, the white pixels are going to disappear. And then Ctrl or Command D to deselect that selection. I'll add a new white filled layer beneath this so I don't see the transparency mesh. To do that, Ctrl or Command click on the new icon and the layer appears immediately under the existing layer. White over here is my background color, so I can press Ctrl Backspace, Command Delete on the Mac to fill that layer with white. If white were the foreground color, it would be Alt Backspace, Option Delete. So let's see how good our background removal was, and there's a very simple test for this. What we'll do is select our line art layer and we'll go to the FX icon here and choose Stroke. And what we'll do is make sure we set a red color or a color that's really, really obvious. We're going to make it positioned in the center. It's really important that it's in the center, not on the outside or the inside. So make it in the center and make it big enough that you can see the dots in the document. And I'm going to make mine just a little bit bigger here. Okay, so I'll click OK. So let's see what we just did. We took a layer that had some transparency on it and we said to Photoshop, around the edges of anything on this layer that has actual content, whether it be black or gray, put a stroke. And so all these little dots are stray pixels. That's really important because if somebody, for example, bought this shape and they went to put a drop shadow on this clown, then each of these dots would have a drop shadow applied to it. And so their document wouldn't be perhaps as they expected it to be. So this is what you do to clean up your line art. We'll go to the eraser tool and you want to select a circular eraser. So let's go and select a circle here and it needs to be 100% hardness. Do not put any softness on this at all because it's an eraser. I'm just going to crank the size up a little bit right now, but we'll do it later as we work. So let me just check and see if I can actually see my eraser. No, I can't. So I'm going to increase its size a little bit. And what we'll do is go over the document with the eraser, and everywhere we see a loose dot, we'll put the eraser dead over the top of it and click once. This is why you have a hard eraser, because you want to see where the brush is going to be erasing. So here, if I considered this to be a dot, I would be in big problems if I click the eraser right now, because I'm going to be eating into this other area over here. So I want to make sure that my brush is resized so that it goes over the top of the dot there, but it doesn't eat into the artwork. So basically, you will go around the document removing the dots by just erasing over the top of them and then looking at the dots on the inside and outside here. You can see that there's going to be a stray pixel in here. So I'll just click over the top of it. I'm removing the stray pixel, but I'm not destroying any of the line artwork. Now, if you have a lot of these dots, you might want to go back and try your magic wand again and just see if you can get a better starting point. But you will expect to find some dots, because the dots are actually helping you. What you're doing is you're not getting all the pixels, you're just getting most of the pixels with the magic wand tool. So you're not eating into the edges of your artwork, because you want to protect some of this line work, because that's why you're doing hand-drawn drawings in the first place, no doubt, is that they just have a different characteristic to them. So be protective of your line work and just assume that you're going to spend a few minutes spotting these images. So I'm going to go ahead and do that and remove all these dots, and I'll come back once I've done that and we'll go on to the next step. So I've gone ahead and spent a few minutes spotting this document. Exactly how many spots you take is up to you. I certainly suggest that you take out any spots that are loose around the character or the drawing, because they're going to be really embarrassing to have in the document. But how close you come into the edges is a personal preference. Now, I left a couple of pieces here. One of them is this bit here, because there's a simple way of doing that. With the eraser tool, you can click once in the document and then shift click, and then the eraser, like any other brush, will paint in a straight line, and so you can remove any edge detail very easily that way. I find using the open and close square bracket keys as I work makes it very easy to change the brush size on the fly. Now, what I didn't remove, you might notice it in here, is any of the dots that appear inside black areas. Because they're not stray pixels, they're holes in the black. So they're areas of the black where I didn't quite color it in exactly. And so we don't want to start removing those, because if we start removing those, they're actually just going to grow. So the more we start removing them, you can see that his entire nose is being eaten away here. So that's not the solution for those areas. So I've done that now. I'm going to go back and get the layers palette. I'm just pressing F7 to do that. At this point, we'll just remove the stroke. So grab the stroke and drop it onto the trash can, because you don't need it any longer. All it was doing was being a reference point for loose pixels or stray pixels. So now you've extracted your line work from the background. You can go ahead and fix up these areas where there are pixels missing if you want to, but you might find that that's actually the character that you want to give the piece. So that's entirely up to you. If you want to get rid of them, I suggest you go to the eyedropper tool and sample the color around here, because it's probably not black, but it's probably something dark. And then just go and get a brush, a nice round brush, and I suggest you work with a hard round brush again and just spot these areas. So don't paint over them, because you don't want to destroy any other texture around them, but you can see them pretty obviously and you can just fix the worst of them, or however many of them you want to do for your own personal preference. You're the artist, you just need to know how to fix these things up to your needs. Now, if we have a look in here, let's just go in close. You might see that there's a lot of color noise in here. This has been scanned, not in black and white, but in color. And so there are all sorts of colors in here. If you don't want that color, if you just want it to be black and white and gray, then you can choose image adjustments and then just go to desaturate. This is not the best tool for turning things into grayscale at any other time, but it works perfectly here. So you're just going to desaturate it, which will give you black and gray pixels instead of color noise, which is what I had there. It's going to depend though on how you scanned it. Now again, you can see these lines are gray and there's a lot of texture in them. If you want them to be darker, here's how you're going to do it. Grab the layer that has the content on it and drag and drop it onto the new icon, so you end up with two layers. Go to the topmost layer and set the blend mode to multiply. and that will darken up the lines. This is the before, this is the after. And if that's not enough, just drag this topmost layer that already has the multiply blend mode on it and drop it onto the new layer icon, and you'll get an extra multiply. At some point you're not going to get any change, but you can darken up the edges if you want to doing that. Once you've done that, Control or Command E on the topmost layer just merges these down. So we've merged it all down to a single layer. So we have line art and a separate background. This is now done to the point where you could do a little bit of cloning, perhaps if you needed to fill in areas or if you were a little bit disturbed about some area or how it looked. But assuming that everything looks fine to you here right now, what you might encounter and what's often encountered is that your lines aren't heavy enough. And that's a real problem because there is, on the face of it, no really easy solution. So I'm going to show you what I do when lines need to be thickened. I'll target the line work layer and choose Filter, Other, Minimum. This is a filter that is not here for the purpose of thickening up lines, but it does a really good job of it. You'll want to set this to roundness, not squareness. With squareness, you get a lot less value on these radius sliders, so I usually choose roundness. And now you can set a radius, and as you do that, your lines get thicker. So let's just click OK here, and then let's do a before and after. So this is the before, and this is the after. Obviously, there's a whole lot of variety between those two points. It's not sort of this or that, but you can thicken up line work should you wish to do so using that filter. It's Filter, Other, Minimum. Now you're choosing minimum because what you're saying to Photoshop is, I want the minimum line weight to be this value. And if the lines aren't that value already, then they're going to be increased. The flip side is, if you want to thin your lines, you might get some value. I can't promise that it's going to work, but you can try it with Filter, Other, Maximum. Here you're saying, I want my maximum line weight to be this value, and you can bring your radii down really, really small. I've got 0.2 here, and you may get some value in thinning your lines. Try it. It often can save you from having to redraw your artwork. I hope that you've enjoyed learning these Photoshop techniques. Let us know what you think in the comments below and give us a thumbs up if you enjoyed this tutorial. Until next time, I'm Helen Bradley for Design Cuts.